did quite well for a while, but it just, the heart had suffered too much damage over the years and just couldn't recover. In June of 2015, at 11:20 at night, I recall it very well, I woke up having trouble breathing, and I've never really passed out in my life, and told my wife, I said, that I think I'm going to pass out here. Basically, your heart just flutters until no blood's going anywhere in the right direction, and it just stops. And I neglected to tell you, they put a defibrillator in my chest after the valve surgery. And at that moment, it hit me. And they had forgotten to tell me what kind of a hit it was. It was like being hit by a 220-pound linebacker. It knocked me right over flat on my back on the bed. But it brought me back to life. In the beginning, I walked around, but as things went downhill, the strength left. And Dr. D'Onofrio told me, he said, you really need to be in here to be able to be at the top of the list. Facilities like Tufts, the staff, and Dave D'Onofrio is very selective. His staff is just the best. Their ability, their skill dealing with people is just phenomenal. And I knew I was at a place that they would either make me better or I'd go to sleep and I wouldn't wake up. And I mean, that happens to everybody at some time. But watching the people around me suffer was the people that were the closest. That was the most difficult part. But I could feel systems shutting down, your digestive tract. My sense of taste had gone completely. You can feel the organs shutting down. I liken it to your brain telling certain organs, well, you're going to have to go on an unpaid leave because all the energy has to go to the heart for now, just until we can try to hold on. And at the end, that's all you can feel. Well, I was gray, and I'd lost over 50 pounds. I weighed about 117 pounds when I was admitted to the ICU. My family and friends, I just was astounded at the way they rallied around me. But it was very difficult because they were watching me die. And to see that in their faces was very, very difficult. That was the hardest part. One of the nurse practitioners who I became very close to told me recently, I still keep in touch with her, that she stayed with me the night before the transplant, I was told that the heart was in. And the reason was, she told me she didn't really expect to see me the next day. 7 o'clock at night, I had a phone call, and it was one of my NPs saying, your heart's here, Dave. And I said, you kidding? She said, no, it's here, tomorrow morning. So I heard the news at 7 o'clock at night, and the next day at 7 o'clock in the morning on the 7th day of January, my new heart arrived. Talking with the donor family, why after 3 days of agonizing did they decide that night, the night that a lot of people in the hospital thought was my last night, why'd they decide then? There are a tremendous number of coincidences. And again, you can just add it up to coincidence. I like to think that there was a little more going on. There's something greater than we are, I truly believe. I was kept under sedation for 24 hours. I was awake. They need to let your body acclimate to this new, become the host to this new organ. And when I woke up, I'm one of those fortunate people that anesthesia, I usually wake up, blink my eyes a few times, and my body metabolizes it. Now, I did have painkillers, obviously, but the anesthesia, that's what I was finding. And I just woke up and this is good. This is really feels great. Until you have been in the condition when you couldn't fill your lungs and when you did feel cold all the time, and then feeling this again, it's a phenomenon. There's no words to describe it. I just can't find them. But at first, it was very difficult to do much of anything, but I sure wanted to because I could feel. You can just feel the life force again. Well, I had been a member of the Wellness Center before, and that is one of the things, as my doctor said, that's one of the reasons I survived long enough to be able to receive the heart, because I did my best and had help here with the trainers and the staff here to keep in shape. They've worked with me to increase repetitions, weights, and add a few other programs, but I intend to do that as long as I can. It's just too much of a remarkable change to let it go. Each one of these trainers talking with me and never believing I had any limits. Never letting me believe that I had any limits. Cross-country skiing, bringing firewood in, snowshoeing, doing things that I hadn't been able to do for years. And you realize, now, this is my heart now, but it was someone else's, and it loved other people, and it was loved by other people. And that never leaves your mind. You realize all of a sudden that you've been given a gift that very, very few people can ever have. And it's, there is no good way to describe it. It's a life-changing moment. It's a life-changing moment. My friends, when they've come to see me, said, well, same old Dave's back, well, I'm back, but with a different perspective. I didn't receive this heart to sit in my living room and look out the window. I'm gonna take very, very good care of it, but I'm also gonna give it one hell of a ride because it deserves it, and I have another chance, and that's the way it's gonna be.